Welcome. In this lesson, we're going to have several short presentations about number systems, including the binary number system. An important principle in computer science is that binary numbers are used to represent all computer data. That means they represent numbers, letters in text, our documents and our text messages, images, our photographs, machine language instructions, our videos and our music. In fact, every kind of data you can find on a computer is represented with binary numbers. The binary system is very similar to the decimal system. Both are considered positional number systems. That means that the value of a particular digit, like the digit 5 in 542, depends on its place. So 5 is in the hundreds place, so it represents 500, and 4 is in the tens place, so it represents 40. Now the decimal system is a base 10 system. It has 10 digits, 0 through 9, and the place values are all powers of 10. There's the ones place, the tens place, the hundreds place, and each place value is the previous place value times 10. So the tens place is 10 times the ones place. The binary system works the same way. Its digits have a value that is represented by their position. So 101, the first digit on the left, has a place value of 4, whereas the 1 on the right has a place value of 1. Because the binary system is a base 2 system, it has two digits, 0 and 1, and its place values are powers of 2. So there's the 1's place, the 2's place, the 4's place, the 8's place, and so on, where each place value is the previous place times 2. That's why this one over here is the 4's place, the 1's place, the 2's place, the 4's place. Why do computers use binary? Well, that's simple. In electronic circuits, it's easy to represent the difference between a switch being on or off, or a voltage being high or low. On the other hand, it's hard to represent 10 distinct states. What would that be like? Really high voltage? Pretty high voltage? Pretty low voltage? So those would be difficult states to distinguish. So, before we go on, there's this one amazing fact you have to remember, and that is by combining zeros and ones in various combinations, we can represent any and all the data that computers use and process.